Very good evening, my friends. How are you? Hope you guys are doing very well, and welcome on this new weekly market analysis video from Extreme Trader. This is Salah speaking. So actually, I just wanted to say here one thing. This was not our best week in the premium Forex signals group. Monday and Tuesday were actually really good and we ended them in a good profit, but sadly the days onward were actually not that good. As we can see also here, Friday we have sent the announcement to close the current positions as they are. Three of the signals were running in profit, meanwhile three others were running in loss. But if we did not send this announcement, this could have been the results of Friday if we didn't close the signals. USDCHF ended up in 25 pips of profit. Pound CHF could have ended in 31 pips. CAT CHF could have ended in 32 pips, and so on. So what happened on Friday is we just got worried about the results. The market actually was really confusing on Friday, not to mention of course the comments attack on YouTube, and it was really bad behavior from some of the clients. We actually couldn't take it anymore and we got tired emotionally, so we had to close these signals. What I wanted to say here is, thankfully in Extreme Trader Forex Signals Group, every week we are finishing with more than 500 pips of profit at least, and some other weeks we are ending with more than a thousand pips of profit. Now, what happened is the past 3 days were not that good. And of course, you can never judge the service over only 3 days only. You have to wait for the service no less than a month of trying to judge it first. Those who have joined the premium group recently, they are free to check our score results in the past few weeks, and they can check by themselves that thankfully most of the days we are actually ending in a very good profit. The losses are tiny and small, but however, thankfully, look at that, the profits always are very big, thankfully. So of course, we will do our best to recover by next week, and hopefully everyone will be very happy and satisfied with the service. So if you wish to join Extreme Trader Forex Signals Group, please contact our support. You can find their contact details in the description below this video. Contact them today and hopefully we will see you there. All right, my friends. So let's now start with the weekly analysis. And I just wanted to make a quick review about the analysis that I have sent on the last midweek analysis video. EURUSD has reversed exactly where I have expected it to reverse from, and the pair has actually went all the way to the take profit level, making 106 pips of profit. Pound USD did not work at all. As you can see right here, the pair has reversed for a few pips only at the entry point, but eventually the pair has actually given up on that level of the resistance right here and went down below our entry level and exceeding the safe zone. AUD USD has reversed two times actually. The first time was here on the third attempt and again on the fourth attempt, currently running in 43 pips of profit. USD CAD did not actually make the promised breaking out as I was expecting, and as we can see, the pair has immediately fallen down upon that pressure from that resistance. And of course, that time there was of course some news about the CAD. I forgot what the news honestly, and it has actually affected all the CAD pairs. USDGPY has went down as I have predicted, but did not reach our sell level. USDCHF actually running in the profit again, and the pair has reversed for the second time and currently running in 45 pips. The gold signal is right now active. So, and the gold actually running right now in about 23 pips of profit. So let's now begin with the weekly analysis, and let's of course as usual start with the EURUSD. Now the EURUSD, as you can see right here, has actually, let me just first delete the old signals so they won't confuse us. Now, as you can see, my friends, the EURUSD has actually exceeded that long-term resistance right here, exactly right here, on 1.20692. If we check the history, we can see that this level here was a strong resistance. Actually, this is way too thick. That's better. Yeah, we can see that this pair here has faced a strong resistance right here, and also, not to mention, this one. Of course, this one is actually very important level, and this tells us exactly where we can start again now buying the EURUSD right after the retest of the broken resistance. So by depending on this long wick right here, I'm going to decide that we can start buying the EURUSD exactly once the pair actually reverses the strength of that resistance right here on 1.2011. Most likely the EURUSD is going to fall down to make a pullback, retesting the broken resistance, and eventually is going to continue the rise. The target, if the pair is going to continue the rise, will be the peak of the resistance right here at 1.2220. And if we look at the daily chart, on the daily chart, we can notice right here that the EURUSD is actually moving in a very strong upper momentum, upper trend, and most likely the pair actually is going to make another breakout from that downtrend right here, exactly like that. So this was right here, the bullish breakout from that resistance level. So as I said before, most likely what will going to happen is that the pair is going to actually depend on that previous support level right here. That support zone cannot simply be ignored. And again, the pair is actually going to fall down all the way right here, retesting that support, the broken resistance. That support also is going to keep its position as a support. And from that level, we can start again buying the Euro USD. And of course, not to mention this trend right here as well. Exactly like that. Remember, right now I'm on the daily chart. Let's move again to the 4-hour time frame. And let me just draw this the support trend line in the correct way, exactly like that. That's why I'm expecting most likely the Euro USD is going to be valid for the buy right after the retest, and we can keep the trade running all the way till it hits that peak of the resistance. Now, most likely what will happen after the retest, the pair actually is going to rise again, and we can see that right here we had a previous support level, so we can expect from the Euro USD to fall again. And as we can see, it's gonna bounce again on that support trend line. Also, we have right here previous resistance and also previous support level. Also, that level we can depend on. And again, we can start buying the Euro USD. If in case we have missed the first entry, we can expect to actually enter the Euro USD again right after the retest of that broken resistance level. And that support level is gonna keep its position again as a support and continue to buy the Euro USD. That being said, Euro USD is going to be valid for the buy at 1.20692. Let me delete all these lines. I mean, I'm sure they are confusing everyone right now. All right, that's better. And for this, of course, the target will be right here, the peak of the resistance at 1.2220. So therefore, let me just make the take profit level 1.2420. And the safe zone, of course, the safe zone, if you look at the left, we shouldn't pick the safe zone randomly. We have to identify the strongest support levels as well to identify where our safe zone is going to be. And of course, if we look carefully, this is exactly the strong support zone. So if the pair is ever going to be ranging in any level, it's going to be right here. And that's going to be about 46 pips only, no more. Just like that. There goes your signal for the Euro USD this week, and hopefully also it's going to work very well and bring us lots of profits. Let's now take a look at the Pound USD. Now, the first thing we can notice right here on the Pound USD that the pair did not respect that previous resistance, but however, that previous support level right here, exactly on 1.38369, actually is being respected, and the pair seems like it has reversed exactly right on that previous support. So let me just delete the old signal. And let's analyze the Pound USD deeper than that. So if we look at the daily chart, what we can see right here on the daily chart, how the pair is actually moving in a very strong upper trend, exactly like that. And the pair actually has respected that that support trend line for quite a long time. And even right here, we can see that the pair is moving on this channel. And even right here, if we look at that previous support trend line, the pair still respecting it. Now, if we right now we are on the daily chart. Sorry about that. Let's go to the 4-hour time frame. Now, on the 4-hour time frame, we just need to identify the strongest support levels, and by the naked eye, we can notice that right here exactly right here on 1.38495, that support level has been respected quite a long time. And if we look at the market, actually right here, the pair has actually respected that support level. And even right here as well, and right here also, and eventually that level has actually made an attempt to act as a resistance, but eventually the market immediately made the breakout, and again that support level is being respected again as a support, not to mention the support trend line as well. So most likely that means that the Pound USD has actually made the bullish, sorry, not this one, I didn't want to make this one, I wanted to draw a Fibonacci retracement. As we can see, this is actually a Fibonacci retracement 50, and seems like the pound USD has been reversing, and actually right now it's above Fibonacci 50, and therefore we can expect from the pound USD to actually create right here a second attempt of that support, because right here what we are having is a support number one, and therefore we can expect from the pound USD to fall again all the way right here to hit that previous support trend line. So we're gonna have here, we have here two attempts of the support already. On horizontal level, we are having here already support number one, and also on a trend line, we are having also right here another support number one. So the creation of support number two of both of them is gonna be the target where we can start again buying the pound USD. That being said, pound USD is good for the buy at 1.38523. which is going to be the second attempt of the support, and the stop, or not the stop loss, sorry, the safe zone will be ranging just inside that previous support zone right here. So that's going to be ranging for almost 57 pips, which is also fair enough. Of course, if we buy the pound USD right from that level, I just want to fix this one, guys, hold on. No need, okay. If we want to buy the pound USD right here, we have to set a reasonable target. Now, if we look at the left as well, we can see that right here, the pair has faced a major strength of the resistance right here on 1.39936. That's exactly which is going to be our target, because most likely we don't know what will going to happen when the pair reaches that level. If it's going to be able to break out immediately, or if it's going to reverse, all of that is going to be clear at the end of the week, and also or actually when the market reaches that level. So therefore we can expect to be the pair to rise for another 140 pips, which is going to be our profit, hopefully. So therefore the take profit level 1.39936. there goes your signal for the pound USD, and hopefully it will work also very well and bring us lots of profits. Let's now take a look at the AUD USD. Now let me just delete the old signal. As you can see, the AUD USD has actually reversed many times on that previous support level. So that means that the rejection on that level was quite strong. And if we look at the daily chart, we can see here the rejection, as I told you. And after all these attempts and respecting that previous support level, most likely the AUD USD is going to continue the rise. And I'm expecting from the AUD USD to actually make the breakout from that trend line right here, that resistance trend line. The pair is actually on its way to break out from that resistance, and if this happens, we can expect from the AUD USD to continue the rise till it hit the peak of the resistance right here on 0.87360, and after that it's going to fall again all the way, retesting the broken resistance trend line, and after that it's going to continue the rise. Now that is it, of course, guys. We are analyzing right now on the daily chart. That means we just have to wait for a few days for this to happen. However, let's go back to the 4-hour time frame, and let's identify the strongest support levels so we can actually start buying the pair on these levels. So by looking at the left, as I'm telling you always, you have to rely on the long tails. The long tails always telling you where are the strongest levels. This is right here, a long tail, and this tail actually telling me a lot. If we look carefully also, we can see that right here we had another two attempts previously on that very same level of the support, and right here we had another one fake breakout from that previous support level. And of course, not to mention that right here this level has been respected as a support, and also right here it has been respected as a support as well, and right here. So that level of 0.77313 cannot be ignored. Now, after hitting that previous resistance trend line, most likely the AUD USD is going to make another fall to create the pullback. That support level is going to be respected again, and the pair is going to keep its position as a support on that level of 0.77313. And from that level, we can start buying the pair after it falls for another 18 pips only. Therefore, AUD USD will be good for the buy at the level 0.77313. And the safe zone should range actually just a little bit right here below that support level, because if we look carefully also, this was previously a strong support zone. That means that the pair might actually range us for another 41 pips only, which is really fair enough. Just like that. Exactly. And if we started buying the AUD USD from that level, the target has to be the peak of the resistance right here. And I'm telling you, most likely this is what will gonna happen. The pair actually will reverse exactly from that level. And if you see it actually breaking out from that resistance trend line, you should be aware that the pair is actually gonna continue the rise, and most likely it's gonna even exceed that resistance and goes all the way right here to the peak of the resistance at 0.885. However, we have to wait and see what will gonna happen. So the target from the signal of the AUDUSD will be about 103 pips. Hopefully we will make them. So therefore, take profit level 0.78360. There goes your signal for the AUDUSD, and hopefully also it will work very well and bring us lots of profits. Now let's take a look at the USD CAD. The USD CAD actually is very obvious for the short right now. I mean, it's very clear that the pair has actually been ranging. And I told you last week, my friends, this is one of the ugliest markets right now. I just hate seeing the market here. I mean, if you place any kind of order here, if you place any buy or sell, you're going to be ending in profit. If you place buy order, you might see the pair goes in loss for a few pips only before going to be eventually in profit. If you place your buy order right here, you're also going to be in profit. If you place your sell order right here, you might be in loss for some time and again be in profit. I mean, this is a pure gambling. And I really honestly hate this market. But however, still, the market, as we can see, ranging a lot, but still respecting support and resistance levels, believe it or not. If we draw right here, this a resistance trend line, we can see that the fake breakout has happened right here, and most likely the pair has actually let me just explain this again. One second. What I'm trying to say is the USD CAD has actually been respecting this resistance trend line for quite a long time, even right here, by the way. And however, the pair has made what seems like a fake breakout and immediately went down below in that channel again. Now, what happened is that the pair has actually respected that resistance trend line again, not only one time, but twice. That tells us that this pair, even though it's moving randomly, but still is respecting the levels. So therefore, what we can do right here is we can actually start by selling the USD CAD again at the peak of the resistance as 1.24918, because that level was actually a strong resistance in the past, and also it was a strong support. So most likely this resistance is gonna keep its position again. Actually, it is already respecting its level. It's already keeping its position as a resistance. If we draw right here the zone, check that out. That resistance zone, even though the market is moving randomly, that resistance zone right here is still being respected and it's still acting as a resistance. So what I'm trying to say is we have to start shorting the USD CAD right here after it reverses from that previous support level to make another pullback, just like that. And it's going to hit, first of all, it's going to hit the resistance trend line. Second of all, it's going to actually hit the same level of the resistance at 1.24918. That is exactly where we're going to start shorting the pair. Of course, as we can see, USD CAD is moving in ranging mode, actually in consolidation. So therefore, you can expect for the trade to be in loss for some time before finally it goes in profit. So USD CAD good for the sell at 1.24918. And the safe zone is going to be ranging just right here for the peak of that resistance. So only 33 pips, we can make it a little bit more, just like that. Since the pair is, as I said before, is ranging a lot, and the trade might actually goes in loss for quite a long time before finally be in profit. So therefore, this is the edge of the safe zone, just like that. And the take profit, of course, will be the lowest bottom level, or the lowest low level of that support level. So we are talking about 108 pips, hopefully gonna be in a very good profit. So therefore, take profit level 1.23807. There goes your signal for the USD CAD, and hopefully also it will work very well and bring us lots of profits. Now let's take a look at the USD GPY. Actually, surprisingly, USD GPY signal is still gonna be valid from the past week. I mean, I have analyzed the USD GPY for a long time, and I honestly don't see anything needed to be changed right here. The pair actually, this is daily chart, and on Friday night, the market has actually managed to end the day as a pin bar right here. Now, that pin bar doesn't mean at all that the market will change the direction. What I'm expecting is that the USD GPY is gonna rise again right here, retesting that broken support level, and eventually gonna continue the fall. What we're gonna change is only the take profit level. And the take profit level has to be right here, the peak of that previous resistance at 106.935. So this USD GPY signal is just still the same. Just please wait for the pair to rise for another 55 pips before we can start shorting it. And if that happens, we can expect to gain about 148 pips profit from this deal. So let's go back to the 4-hour time frame, and we can see that right here, this support level cannot be ignored, and we can see that right here also the market has created the resistance number one, and again we can start shorting the pair at the second attempt of the resistance. So USDGPY signal is just remains the same. Let's now take a look at the USDCHF. Now USDCHF signal actually it was going in a good profit and still going in profit, but however the pair actually is still gonna be valid for the short. Now it's a matter of where we can start again shorting the USDCHF. Now what we can see right here is that we having here a strong support, a key support level on 0.91361, and the pair has reversed two times already, and right now I'm expecting from the pair to rises for on the third attempt of that previous support level. So therefore that previous resistance right here, as I told you guys, always rely on the long wicks and tails. They are telling you a lot. And right here, the peak of that tail tells me that this one actually was the attempt number one of the resistance after this breakout, and most likely the pair will rise again to create the second attempt of the resistance, and from that level we can start shorting the USDCHF again. This short is still valid for the USDCHF, and even if we look at the daily chart, this price action is a very good indicator for a continuation in the bearish momentum. So that being said, let's go back to the 4-hour time frame, and let's just make sure that the USDCHF is going to be valid for the short right here after it rises for another 30 pips or 31 pips. So therefore, sell the USDCHF at 0.91671. And the safe zone will be ranging just a little bit above that previous resistance zone. So it's going to be ranging for about, let's just make it a little bit more, 46 pips, which is also fair enough. And now for the target. The target, of course, has to be right here, the nearest previous resistance. And as we can see right here, this level right here was a previous support level, and also it was right here also previously another resistance. So therefore this is gonna be our target, my friends. So we can expect to get about 75 pips only from this trade. Sorry my friends, that is what the USDCHF is giving us. So therefore 0.90927 will be our target. There goes your signal for the USDCHF, and hopefully also it will work very well and bring us lots of profits. Now let's take a look at the gold. Now the gold actually has been triggered, but however I believe that the gold actually might fall again after, let me just delete the old signal. So after seeing this strong reversal right here from that previous resistance on 1796, actually I was really quite sure that the gold is going to continue the rise to hit the level 1800 first before it falls down. It reversed just 30 pips only before it reaches it. However, if we look right now at the daily chart, the gold eventually gonna respect that previous support level. And as we can see right here, it has already been respected right here on 1768. But however, after seeing the pair actually has made this price action, now it's not the best time to buy the gold right now. We have to wait for the gold to fall more all the way to hit the lowest level of the support at 1763 before it's going to be valid for the buy. Actually, let's rise it a little bit more to the peak of the resistance right here. 1766.44 is going to be the best level at all to start again buying the gold. We have to keep in our mind that the gold actually is very sensitive and it moves very fast. So therefore, let's pay attention to each and every single candle of them. Let me tell you first, this price action right here, this breakout candle, usually indicates a continuation in the momentum. So most likely, after the creation right here of these two tails actually representing the support number one. And right now the market is on its way to create the support number two on the gold. The same level right here of the peak of that resistance is going to be the same also level of that previous support level right here, and also right here exactly. That's why I'm going to send the signal to start buying the gold exactly at that level. Buy the gold at 1766.44. Now, regarding the safe zone, since, let me just zoom out. So since we are actually relying on that previous support level, we have to look right now at the support zone. This is exactly the support zone. If we look carefully right here, we can see that the pair has been ranging exactly inside that level. And even the previous broken resistance actually was ranging inside that zone. That means the safe zone will be ranging for about 130 pips. Now for the take profit level, let's give a realistic take profit level this time. And actually, as I said before, I'm expecting from the gold to rise all the way to hit the level 1800. But sadly, I just want to be sure. So therefore, the target will be just the peak of the resistance right here at 1796, which means we're going to be aiming about 300 pips from buying the gold. This is exactly how it looks like. This is our signal for the gold. I think it's going to be really a good signal. So therefore, the take profit level is going to be the peak of the resistance at 1796. Actually, that's it. You have, my friends, to keep your eyes on the gold if it has reversed exactly what I'm expecting, and if you see it actually has reached the take profit level. What you can do, if you want, close the trade and open another one with another buy order, but just risk a few parts of the profits that you have made from this buy order. For example, if you have made $1,000 from this deal of buying the gold, open another trade risking only $300 as investment on the next trade, because I'm expecting, really, if the gold gonna rise right here to hit that previous resistance, most likely the rise is gonna huge, and we can expect from the gold to fly above 1800 and gonna go all the way to 1815 will be the next target if the pair is actually gonna ever make a breakout from that previous resistance. So there goes your signal for the gold and all the pairs for this week. And I think it's going to be a very good and profitable week for everyone. And guys, please, again, be extra careful and trade wisely. And always remember, the secret of being a successful Forex trader is always the proper money management, not the strategy itself. So in the end, I hope that was informative to you. And I would like to thank you for watching.